And Albert is going to continue, and in a little while, Natasha will be here to explain to you about the outpatient clinic. Okay?
Listen, thank you very much.
Thank you.
Yes, as she said, my name is Albert Fernandez. I've been in the community for, 15 years dealing with psychiatric patients. Anyway, is everybody familiar with Bagarac? Everybody? Nobody? Everybody knows that? Okay, fine. As you know, that's a unique thing in the state of Florida, not necessarily anywhere else, even though it's used in different states. But it's unique in the state of Florida. Some people don't particularly like it. Some people do. It's a necessary evil, so to speak. I deal with a lot of different places. I deal with private houses. I deal with ALFs, which are assisted living facilities. I deal with nursing homes. I deal with the police on the street because I have some very serious issues. Actually, I never really dressed like this because I'm usually dressed on the street because it's nice and hot. And all these ALFs are very hot, too. And the type of clientele I deal with can get very violent at times. So you don't see any of those things, but what you really do see is, if you're working in the emergency room, is when I send somebody there who has a, which is, a lot of people use the word called ex parte. You familiar with that word too? Ex parte is a, it's by a judge or a police officer initiating involuntary examination for a person who needs to be examined. Remember, the whole thing about Bagarac or ex parte is to get somebody into the hospital to be examined. Doesn't mean you're hospitalizing them. It means the state of Florida is trying to say, hey, listen, we need a certain amount of time to get this person to the hospital so we can find out what's happening and evaluate them so we can see if there's any more needs. And as probably most of you know, that's up to 72 hours. And after that period of time, you know, there's probably other legal means going in, which I really don't even know at this point because I really don't deal with that. I'm usually in the community. You want to find a chair? There's a chair right here. So you can be right next to me. I lost my train of thought.
Sorry.
Thank you. You know, what's his name? Albert Einstein once said that when he was at Princeton University years ago, he was walking, and he said to everybody, he said to these students, he said, which way was I walking? I says, oh, Dr. Einstein, you're walking to the mathematical building. I says, oh, yes. The moral of the story is great minds tend to forget. Anyway, ex parte Bagarac is very similar. The difference in Bagarac to ex parte, Bagarac is really done by professionals like clinical psychologists, social workers, and people like that. Just to briefly tell you what those type of people may be, they stretch the law to extend a little bit more people. It used to be just a few, but now it's licensed mental health counselors, licensed clinical social workers, psychologists, advanced registered nurse practitioners or specialized in psychiatrists, and a few other in there. Do you have any questions so far about that? No. You want to get this out of the way and go, okay, I understand. So, anyway, when I initiate a Bagarac, remember, it's not an ex parte, it's a Bagarac. I'm doing it because I'm a professional. If it's a police officer, somebody else, it's called a Bagarac. It's really called a certificate, a professional certificate. Certificate of professional, that's what they really call it. I'm just using slogans back and forth. This is what it looks like. Has anybody ever seen this form before? All right, fine. I actually designed my own form, even though it's almost the same, to include a few little, you know, things in there, but that doesn't really matter. Now, what Odette has been saying over and over again is that in the community, since Larkin is a community hospital, trying to prevent people from going to the hospital for no reason whatsoever.